Do you know what Twitter, LinkedIn, Netflix, The Verge, and probably a lot more of very popular websites have in common? They all offer a dark mode. Well, some of them only a dark mode, and they are doing a great job at that. But they are not using a color scheme property, and color scheme makes a huge difference to certain parts of user interface. In this video, I will explain how color scheme works, why you should use it when you're supporting a dark mode, and I will even demonstrate what difference it makes if you apply color scheme to the websites I have just mentioned. Let's dive in. Okay, I have created a demo on CodePen to demonstrate this. You're gonna find the link in the description if you wanna check out the code. I have created a little bit of HTML here. I've added a form, a couple of inputs, text area, and a button. And I've added a little bit of CSS, but if you dig into it, you're gonna notice that there's no colors here whatsoever. So this is pretty much the styling that comes from the default browser style sheets. And now let's see what color scheme is. So color scheme property tells the browser in which color schemes can the page or certain elements of the page be comfortably rendered in. And the browser will then use this knowledge to apply certain changes to the native HTML elements and render them a little bit differently based on that knowledge. And this is going to be applied to scroll bars, form controls, and more. Let's see how it works. So first thing to note is that I'm using a light theme in my system preferences. And on Mac, you can find this if you go into system preferences, general. And right here, the first option is going to be the appearance, which you can switch from light to dark. And right now I have a light theme selected. So let's try applying color scheme to the root of our document, which means that the color scheme is going to be applied to the entirety of our page. And we will tell the browser that this page can be rendered both in light and in dark mode. So let's see what difference it makes if we switch to the dark mode. You can see that immediately our entire page has changed and we have not added any kind of colors to our style sheet. We're basically just using default styling with the margins and paddings. And you're gonna notice that all our native elements have been switched to the dark mode, like the scroll bar here, the form inputs, and even the form controls. If you wanna apply the color scheme to the entire page, you can also do this with the meta tag. So let's just remove this one. And on CodePen, you can add things into your head. If you go into settings, HTML, stuff for head. So you can add meta tags here. Let's do meta. And it's going to work exactly the same as it did in CSS. Name is going to be color scheme. And the content is going to be light, dark. And as you can see, this already works. If we were to switch back to light mode, our interface will switch to light. And if we're using dark, it's going to switch to dark. The advantage of using the meta tag is that the browser will know immediately, even before your CSS has been downloaded and parsed, in which color scheme the page should be rendered, which is obviously a good thing. So if you can, use it in a meta tag. And this is basically how you tell the browser that your entire page can be rendered in light or dark mode using the meta tag or using the CSS property. But if you use the CSS property, you can tell the browser that you only want certain part of your interface to be rendered in a dark mode. For example, maybe we want our page to be light mode, but just our form to be in light and dark mode. We're gonna remove stuff from our head here. And we could do that if we apply color scheme to our form element. And as we're currently using dark mode, you can see this in our system preferences, our elements have been switched to dark mode. But the background of our element where we set the selector was not switched. This only happens if you use it on the root element. So if you use it on a div or anything like that, it's not going to automatically switch to black. You're gonna have to do that yourself. So we're gonna have to tell the browser that we want the background of our form to be black and text white by ourselves. And we can do that if we use Prefers Color Scheme Media Query. Prefers Color Scheme Media Query works in sync with Color Scheme Property. Color scheme property tells the browser what color schemes we support on a certain element. And with Prefers Media Query, we can tell the browser how we want to style those elements when a certain theme is active. Or in this case, when we have a dark mode, we're gonna use media, prefers color scheme, and we will set background color on our form and our text color. With this, we have told the browser that our form can be rendered both in dark and light modes. And when the dark mode is active, we will render colors of our form differently. So if we switch to light mode, we're gonna see our default version, and if we switch back to dark mode, we're gonna see the dark interface right here. So everything is in dark, and here everything is in light mode. So whenever you specify in color schemes, you want to make sure that you use color scheme property and the media prefers color scheme, and those work in sync well. But what if you're not using prefers color scheme property, but rather you have a custom switcher that switches from light to dark theme? Well, you can support that as well. And in that case, you can set the color scheme of your page just to the theme that is active. So you don't use a prefers color scheme media query. For example, let's just say that the user has opted in to use a dark mode. You would apply dark color scheme to the root element. And in this case, the page will be rendered in dark regardless of the settings in your system. So we have a light theme selected here, but our page is still rendered in dark. And likewise, if the user switches to light mode, you can use light color scheme here as well. And now all interface elements will be rendered in that color scheme. A bit of a warning here, before you apply color scheme to your entire web page, make sure that your elements work fine, so test everything properly. So for example, CodePen here doesn't use a color scheme property, but they are using some custom styling for certain parts of their interface. And if we go into settings, you're gonna notice that there are some white parts of the user interface, like this scroll bar here. And you don't want to just apply color scheme to the entirety of the page, because this is what can happen. And let's switch to dark mode now. Now this looks out of sync. So if you have styled certain elements, certain native elements in a way that they work well in a dark mode, even though they are not truly rendered in the dark color scheme, you wanna make sure that you check them, that you change them, and that you apply any necessary changes to your CSS to have this work properly. And now for the fun part, let's see how Twitter, LinkedIn, Netflix, and The Verge look if we apply color scheme property. But before we do, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss my future videos. Now, let's see how Twitter looks. And we're gonna switch to dark mode here, because that's where we're gonna see the difference. And the difference is that native elements like the scroll bar right here and scroll bars in other parts of interface, like maybe here, those elements seem like they're out of place because they are. Everything is in dark mode except for those few random elements. So let's try applying color scheme, and we're gonna tell the browser that we support both light and dark mode. There we go. And this scroll bar now doesn't look like it's out of place, and this one as well. And nothing basically looks like it's taken out for no good reason. And while we're at the subject of Twitter, you're gonna find me at CSS Weekly. So make sure to follow me, because I'm sharing a lot of interesting and useful links and a lot of interesting tips, like this one about the hash selector, for example, that's pinned right here. And next, let's see how LinkedIn looks with the color scheme property. On LinkedIn as well, you're gonna find that the interface elements like scroll bars are rendered in white, while the rest of the interface is rendered in dark. And if you try to play around with it, you're gonna see that there are various parts of interface that look like they're out of place right here. So let's apply color scheme to that page as well. And again, we're gonna apply it to the entire page. And this makes a big difference. Now, all of those elements are no longer sticking out. They look like they're in sync with the rest of the design, and everything works much better. And another thing to note here is that this is going to be mainly visible if you're using a mouse. You're gonna find this in system preferences under show scroll bars. If you use automatically based on mouse or trackpad, and you mainly use trackpad, you may not even notice this subtle difference. But if you're using a mouse, you're gonna see a big, big difference, and a lot of the elements of the interface are gonna stick out, and they're gonna just look like they're really, really not belonging where they are. Now let's see how Netflix looks. And again, you're gonna notice that the scroll bar here looks like it's out of place. It's rendered in the light color scheme while the rest of the interface is in dark. And the thing to note here is that Netflix doesn't offer a light color scheme. You just wanna tell the browser that we only support dark color scheme on this page. And we're gonna do that by adding color scheme property to the root element. And there we go. Now this looks much better, and it no longer looks like it's out of place. For the final example, let's look at The Verge. And The Verge basically renders parts of their interface in dark and parts in light. For example, homepage is in dark mode and this scroll bar doesn't look like it's in the place, while the article view is in light mode and everything looks as it should. So we would just want to apply dark mode to our homepage here. And this is how scroll bar would look if you applied a color scheme here as well. And have you noticed any web pages that don't use a color scheme property but they should? Let me know in the comments. I'm really curious to see how many are there. I hope you found this helpful, I hope you found this interesting, and I hope you start using the color scheme property. My name is Zoran Jambor, thank you so much for your attention. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and I will see and hear you in the next video.